It's been over a year since COVID-19 made its unprecedented mark on the world. But even though the vaccine is here, there's one thing that everyone's talking about.
The FDA has authorized two different vaccines for the COVID-19 virus. 6 million Americans and counting have received the first dose, and some their second. This puts the U.S. on a path to herd immunity, where a sufficient proportion of the population is immune to COVID-19. Experts estimate that 80 to 90% of the population would need to be immune in order to reach this goal. Vaccination is a critical part of this, but distrust is growing as more and more media outlets are reporting allergic reactions and even death among people who received the vaccine. Should people be taking these scary headlines at face value?
Our good friend, Dr. Orden, is here with me all day today for the ride. Hey, Drew.
Welcome, man. How are you doing, Ian? Great to be here.
We wanted to hear what our viewers thought, so we polled them by asking, will you get the vaccine when it's your turn? Believe it or not, 22,000 people voted, and 54% said no.
I think that's a sad state of affairs that many people have that many concerns about the vaccine.
You know, on social media, some of our viewers were saying things like, my body is my immune system, or humans are basically the test rats for this vaccine. Scientists have no idea of the side effects that it may cause. Some even said, if it's going to make me sick, as the flu shot does, then I just don't have the option of being off work to be sick. Well, Drew, I'd like to bring in Lily. She's a 23-year-old biochemistry major who says she's actually hesitant about getting the vaccine. I also want to bring in a good friend to the show, Dr. Brad Spellberg. He's an infectious disease expert and the medical director of biosciences for Los Angeles County. Thank you both for joining us today.
Thank you.
Thank you. So,
Lily, I want to start with you. Lots of people are concerned about getting the COVID vaccine. What are your concerns?
Yeah, I have some pretty severe allergies to dust mites, some seasonal allergies, and some food allergies. And some of the news articles that I've read have said that if you have allergies, the vaccine could potentially be dangerous and cause an anaphylactic reaction.
Dr. Spellberg, you want to weigh in on that?
The incidence of severe allergic reactions to the COVID vaccines is currently estimated to be about 1 in 100,000. So that's pretty low. And it has nothing to do with the history of allergies to anything other than the constituents of the vaccine itself. In particular, there is a particular component called polyethylene glycol that people may think is the source of most of these allergies. If you've not had an allergic reaction to that in the past, it's not a concern.